Bill Nye, you've been busy lately saving the world, and you're a big fan of science, so I thought, why not talk about superhero science?
Yeah, right. Yeah, superhero science.
Superhero science.
Yeah, let's have some fun. I wanted to talk about if things are possible or plausible in some of our favorite science fiction. So I wanted to start with an iconic
You can't do that. That's Thor's hammer. You can't. Are you empowered?
Thor flies by spinning it around really fast, throwing it, and hanging on for the ride.
You have an intuitive sense of it. When you swing a bowling ball or a bucket of water, you can knock yourself over. You're converting this angular momentum to a linear momentum.
What about Wonder Woman's lasso? It compels people to tell the truth. And we know that truth serums exist.
There's no science of the lasso of truth. However, maybe there is when someone is caught in a lie. That's the verb we use, right? So if you're caught in the lariat of truth, then you've got to tell the truth. When you're caught in a lie, then you start telling the truth.
The Flash. Going as fast as he does, it would have an effect on your body. And he has a super suit. But I always think about how the fact that his face is not protected, and I wonder what would that do to your skin to travel really, really, really fast?
The Flash runs at supersonic speeds, or near supersonic speeds, and his face is unaffected. So his face must be stronger than yours and mine.
What would happen to our faces?
I watch the guys on the rocket sleds, where their or the guys ejected from airplanes. Who survive it, their faces get blown up by the wind.
One of my favorite movies, The Rocketeer. Where are we on jetpacks? Is it possible to have a jetpack and fly, or are we just gonna burn our butts?
So there is not enough energy in alcohol, which is the supposed fuel, to fly a guy around like that. However, there are rocket packs that use hydrazine, and hydrazine is conventional rocket fuel. It's very energetic. You don't have to light it, you just need a catalyst to start it.
You got Captain America's shield. That's a material that absorbs the impact.
Vibranium.
Right.
So this is a classic second order differential equation. The spring depends on how much you compress it, how fast. The damping depends just on how fast. So the more you squeeze it, the more it pushes back. So vibranium, Captain America's shield, has great damping.
Spiderman, a material that is condensed enough that can
hold, you can thwip
and hold the weight of a 15-year-old boy.
Yeah, well,
where are we on the science of that?
And some bad guys.
Hey, could you do me a favor? Hold on to that. Does anybody
fight? He has the thwippable web material that squirts out, sticks to buildings, and can support his weight. And he's so skilled, he can make that spiral web pattern just like that.
Are we getting any closer to having that material be real?
Yes. So goats have been genetically modified so that their milk produces the proteins of spider webs. And I remember when I was working full-time as an engineer, U.S. Navy was very interested in this material. So the very near future may have spider web protein material everywhere, the same way we have plastic everywhere.
All right, I'll let you go. I know you have a lot more world
saving
to do.
Oh, are you kidding? We are busy and important. Thank you very much for having us. And, you know, watch out for this hammer.
Yeah, don't watch it. Don't watch it to strangers.